Hello guys, Ganetto here, and this time we have some Mirror Cup action featuring the Boulder Cup. Let's see how we go. Okay, first opponent, Apoelas from Cyprus. Simple matchup here. We have the Swampert, he has the Skarmory. We will seal that Sky Attack, and as you can see, we seal the Sky Attacks, he will seal all of our Hydro Cannons. Not a bad thing for us, because we can charge that last Hydro Cannon much faster than his Sky Attack. We are just one step ahead, because that Swampert is amazing, really squishy but amazing. And as you can see the whole video, the best possible team for this not very good tournament, the Boulder Cup, is the Medicham, the Swampert and the Skarmory. It really depends on what you will use first. The Torterra going to match to that Skarmory, because Medicham is an amazing lead. As far considering the option of the Swampert, also keep in mind that you have that Skarmory in the back, never use it as a lead. That's what I figured out at least, and make some critical changes whenever it is needed. Okay, that Ice Punch would take out this Torterra immediately, so it won't be much problem for us. We take the first win of the two. And next, that booty shaking from that shiny booty Pokemon, the Medicham. We will go right straight ahead with that Power Punch, and I really regret that I didn't hear what Battle Hero said to his video. Use Psychic over the Ice Punch, because those Mirror Cup, Mirror Battles, see what I did there? Yep, I didn't see it either. Are pretty easy with that Psychic. You will deal a lot of damage, almost 80% I think, of the opponent's Medicham, instead of just exchanging Power Up Punches. And with immediately KO, he uses his Skarmory, I use my Swampert, and we saw it before how this matchup works. We both have shields, he uses his first one, and at this point we use ours, he will use his, and then we will use yet again our shield, hitting those excellence one after another. One more Hydro Cannon, and because we, most of us at least, use the same team, Medicham, Skarmory and Swampert, just changing the leads between those three. I was using between those two, Medicham and Swampert. I had to really up my game. I will tell you in a while what I was thinking about to do. And we have to see that second Hydro Cannon to take out his Swampert, to farm a bit, not just a bit, to that Sky Attack, and take out his Skarmory. Lags here, but I think that even though without lags, with Swampert in the back, we still had this matchup. And GG Apoelas from Cyprus. Next, it's Mr. Loizos. The same matchup. You will see it plenty of times, not only in this video, but on this tournament also. Sky Attacks coming second to that Hydro Cannon. And what I was talking before, if I had to really up my game and make something better than my opponent, was to just count those fast attacks and make some critical changes, something that I didn't manage to do here. I don't know why I switched to that Medicham. Anyway, I had to really make some critical changes, because if I could just absorb some of the charge attacks instead of just using a shield, then I could just win my matches a little bit easier. So we take that Sky Attack here. It's not a very effective move, so it will not do much of a damage to us. And he uses a Melmetal. We have that Skarmory with a Flash Cannon ready, which means that we have at least two Sky Attacks ready. And we can land that Earthquake to that Melmetal, taking down. And the Hydro Cannon to the Flygon, a Pokemon which is pretty amazing, but even squishier than the Swampert. And we take the Dragon Claw, which is really good, because we were already going to faint. And the Sky Attack will take out the Flygon. first match goes to us, and next up, the same matchup, instead of the Boulder Cup, they can call it the Boredom Cup, no? Yeah, I think that they can, the Boredom Cup. The same matches all over again, yet again. One more accident for the Hydro Cannon. And what I was talking before, to continue my saying, if you make the critical change at the right time, if you count the right fast moves of your opponents, then you can just switch to your Pokemon, absorb the damage, and finish him by farming for the charge move for your next Pokemon. Like here, I immediately switch to my Skarmory. He has the Mud Bomb, so we absorb the damage, we take almost no damage, he uses his Steelix to take us down, and I know that I can do much vs Steelix with my Skarmory, but I can deal some damage with that Flash Cannon. And after that Flash Cannon, as you can see, right here I think, yes, he will use an Earthquake, and I didn't know that I was so close to that Flash Cannon, and I didn't know that I would survive that Earthquake, but anyways, the Sky Attack lands. Instead of the Flash Cannon, we have the Medicham ready with a Power Punch, which will take out his Whiskas and the Steelix with just counters. Pretty much good games with Mr. Luizos. Next opponent, Novaridis. This was the first time that I used the Torterra, and I really regret it, because Torterra is an amazing Pokemon, but the only thing that you can do is take out the Swampert, nothing else. You can set the first match after I hit that Sky Attack and take a Power Punch right to the gut of that Skarmory. Unfortunately, take us down after a bit of lags, but I think it was on both ends. We use the Medicham here and use that Power Punch as soon as as fast as we can. He uses his Skarmory now, but it's a pretty even matchup for us, because those Power Punches will hurt as long as we have a Silph that Skarmory. We have to block that Sky Attack, it would have taken us out, and we know that he has a Swampert, so the Torterra can just finish him off and grant us the first win of the match. Almost taken us out with that Hydro Cannon. I really expect less damage than that. Anyway, the second booty makes his return on the lead screen, exchanging Power Punches. He has the CMP on this match. Power Punch after Power Punch. Guys, use the Psychic. If you have a Psychic, use it. I don't think that you will play another Boulder Cup anytime soon, but if you do, just for fun, use a Psychic Medicham. Really useful. And we use that Skarmory to absorb the damage of that Power Punch and possibly farm. But he uses his Medicham. With Mud Shots he will deal no damage to us, but the Hydro Cannons will hurt. We have seen this matchup before, but we were in the opposite situation. We will try to land the Sky Attacks, but the Hydro Cannon will deal much of damage to us. I didn't expect him to take us down with just Mud Shots. Really unexpected and bad for us. Maybe I should find a better IV Skarmory out there. And the Power Punch will not take down his Swampert. He has a seat, he has 3 Pokemon as he retrieved the Swampert. And at this point we are pretty much done. We will use the Hydro Cannon. He will shield. And we will manage to reach the second Hydro Cannon here. But it won't be enough, as he has just 1 HP, I think, maybe 2 or 3, I don't know. Doesn't matter, Sky Attack will do the job and take us down. Next match, Medicham vs the Skarmory. I feel pretty comfortably with that matchup, because he has to use his two shields to take us down. Normally, right? Normally, without any lags, without any missing hits. And we have to seek the second power punch. The sky attack will do the job at this point. But it's the set to shield, as I told you before. And we have one shield and three Pokemon. But I decided to bring my Medicham outside, use the ice punch, we take a ton of damage. And unfortunately for us, again with 1, 2 or 3 HP, he uses a power punch at the last moment. We have power punches ready for the Swampert. I decide to switch at this point, but I couldn't, and that cost me the match. I think, don't judge me so fast. And I noticed this point that if I reach the Stone Age, I might have a chance. Not I might, I will have a chance because I can take out his Swampert, but I was close, not very close, but just close to the Stone Age. So Novaridis takes the win, and we have the first defeat of the Boredom Cup, unfortunately for us. I think it cost me the win, but doesn't matter. Let's head to the final battle. I was the most excited for this match because it was vs my brother. We had to play in a tournament together vs each other from the first Boulder Cup. So we just exchanged power punches. We have the showdown here. I'm the 24, he's the 8. The Ganeto 8. Just exchanging power punches. And I decided to go for the ice punch, but it was not enough. I don't know why I did that. Just run psychic, guys. Psychic. And we have the advantage here because we have farmed a bit with those air slashes from that Medicham. We use the sky attack first. He uses the Hydro Cannon now. We both use a shield. Because we have to, you have seen this matchup before on the whole video. He will shield again, and right now we have to shield also that Hydro Cannon, and we switch immediately to our Swampert. We can take, not pretty comfortably, but we can take that Hydro Cannon. We farmed a little bit over than usual for a second Hydro Cannon to be ready, and we will just hit this Hydro Cannon to the Skarmory, and we will manage to use a second Hydro Cannon here to his Skarmory to almost take it down, but we have a Skarmory who can we have our own Skarmory that can take the sky attack, survive it and finish up the job. Second match, he decides to use the Toxicroak. It was the first time that I saw a Toxicroak on this tournament. I had the Tyranitar, as you can see in my team, which I never used it, but it was an interesting choice. So those Hydro Cannons will do the work if one lands that Toxicroak. He uses his second shield. I didn't count well, but I think that I did what I need to do. He tried to switch at this point, but he couldn't. And we will use that flying move yet again, landing the excellent to his Swampert. The flying minigame is really annoying. I'm getting better, I think, to that. Using my Medicham for this shiny Swampert. And as Zionic said, shinies do more damage. So this is an amazing battle, shiny Swampert versus a shiny Medicham. The shiny booty will go for that power punch and then for the ice punch, for the decent amount of damage to the normal Medicham. We don't have this battle, of course, so we don't have to shield. Use the power punch, a smart choice, but we retreat to the Swampert. We have to shield this one if we want to land a Hydro Cannon. And we do. We do land the Hydro Cannon and take out, just with mud shots, his last Pokemon. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. It was the Boredom Cup from the Mirror Cup, and I really hope that if you ever play in the future any kind of the Boulder Cup, I don't know why, but if you do, just play Psychic over Ice Punch. You will not regret it, and the Mirror Matches, it will perform great. and you will cut your opponents unexpected and you will eventually win the match. Okay trainers, I hope to see you next time, and if you found the video informative or it helped you in another way, or you want to say something, just leave a like, subscribe, or even comment. See you next time!